Hello friends. So today we are going to discuss under unit 6, the clusters and cluster development. I am Kuldeep Kumar, faculty IIBF. So let us proceed. So today what we are going to discuss, what are clusters and why clusters, the types of clusters, advantage, disadvantages, the roles of clusters, setting of clusters, approach to develop cluster strategies, measuring cluster development. So these are the things that we are going to discuss today. So first of all, what is a cluster? So a cluster, if we have a general understanding where in one particular place, one particular area, which is a geographically bound concentration of similar related or complementary business with active channels of business transaction, means in one particular area, if many industries, similar kind of industries are functioning, they are working in one particular area, geographically one particular location, then it is said to be a cluster. But there are certain other things that we have to think about it, discuss about it. What is a cluster? The communication, if we go forward, so the communication and the dialogue that share specialized infrastructure, labor market, services that are faced with common opportunities and threats, means in that particular area, the raw material should be available, that should be used by all the units, by all the manufacturing units or the MSME units. The labor should be there, available locally. All other facilities are available locally. It may be financial facilities also. There may be some regulatory institutions also may be there. Business associations may also be there. So all these things are available locally, and there, if the units are functioning, so it is said to be functioning in a cluster. So point number two, a cluster is a sector and geographical concentration of MSMEs faced with common opportunities and threats. So the threats are the common, opportunities are also common. The product category, product range, market opportunities, and identical factors like location, process, and trade practices also can be building factors for the enterprises to come together as a cluster. So as I told you, gave you often idea about what is a cluster. We are similar kind of industries are functioning geographically in one location with all facilities, all amenities available, using locally, available locally and using them from local resources. And then all other, even the marketing, the transportation, the labor, all things are available at one place. Then it is said to be in a functioning in a cluster. So that is basic idea about the cluster. Some examples we can take. The cotton hosiery product in Ludhiana, so that is a cluster, because if you see in Ludhiana, all over Ludhiana city, which is in northern India, we find the hosiery industry. So this hosiery industry, why it has developed? It may be a natural also, it can be an induced cluster also. We will tell you what is a natural cluster, what is induced cluster in the forthcoming slides. But all these facilities are available, the raw material, the market, all everything is available. So it is said to be a cluster, MSME cluster of cotton hosiery in Ludhiana. Also in Tirupur, in Ludhiana, knitwear cluster is also there. Hosiery cluster is also there, but basically cotton hosiery product is available in Tirupur, it is in south. Knitwear cluster is available in Ludhiana, which is in north. So knitwear cluster and hosiery cluster, these are the two examples we have given. Then we talk about the brass clusters. The brass products are manufactured in Moradabad. So in this, there are thousands and thousands of small units which are manufacturing the brass artware or the brass products, which are being exported also, and these are being sold locally also. So we have discussed three clusters, like knitwear cluster in Ludhiana, partially cotton hosiery also, but cotton hosiery mainly as a product cluster is in Tirupur, that is in south, and the brass products cluster in Moradabad. Then IT cluster, we would have heard about it in Bangalore. There is information technology cluster. Of late, this cluster has developed in Hyderabad also. Hand block printed textile cluster in Jaipur, and handloom cluster in Chanderi. So these are some of the examples we have just quoted here to make the things clear. So the cluster stakeholders, who are the stakeholders in the cluster? Those who are providing the raw material, subcontractors, buyers, exporters, machinery suppliers, because these are mainly MSME units are the manufacturing industries. So machinery suppliers, the support institutions, there are various institutions which are supporting the cluster formation and the cluster development, regulatory agencies, consultants, common facility providers, transporters. Transport is very important because when the products are manufactured, how they will be transported to the to the end users and to the market. And also the raw material has to be purchased, the transportation facility. It may be rail also, it can be by train, or it can be by truck also, or lorry also. So that kind of transport facility should be available in a cluster. Then other service providers that facilitate the production directly and indirectly, the cluster is business associations and the self-help group, SHG, self-help group, cooperatives and non-government organizations, NGOs. So these are some of the stakeholders we have just discussed in the cluster. Some examples we'll give, like we are just talking about the knitwear cluster of Ludhiana. The support enterprises are there, spinners are available, dyers, machinery manufacturers are available there only, machinery import is there, agents are there, machinery importing agents are there, accessory suppliers, yarn dealers and merchant buyers. So these are the support enterprises available for the development of cluster of knitwear in Ludhiana. Then technical support institutions are local knitwear colleges there, women technical, polytechnical and industrial training institutes are there, and various small such colleges and institutes have developed there, which are giving training, technical training for the growth, for the improvement of the know-how of the workers, of the functionaries. Then financial and other support institutions, you know, the developmental institutions and the commercial banks are there in Ludhiana in lot many number. They are financing this industry. Then local industry associations of knitwear manufacturers, exporters, they are the support services providers. Dyers, spinners, we already discussed. So all these entities are the stakeholders of the knitwear cluster Ludhiana. But similarly, if the cluster is any car manufacturer or some other, then this kind of some support institutions will be available there also. Now we'll see. So UNIDO is doing exemplary service in development of the clusters and providing the database for cluster formation. The new stakeholders, new cluster form, new MSME units, they can collect the data, they can collect the information from the website of UNIDO. So as per UNIDO, an industrial cluster should have minimum of 100 registered enterprises. This we are talking about minimum. For handicraft clusters, 50, and for handloom cluster, 500. It should be at least 500 handlooms. So this is the criteria fixed by UNIDO. If the lesser number of units are there, then we may not call it a cluster. We may say that it's just industries are there. But if it is in this proportion, if they are there, in this number, if they are there, then we can call it a cluster as per UNIDO criteria. Now we'll discuss something about what is the natural cluster, what is the induced cluster. Now natural cluster is when the locally available raw material, power, or locally available resources, not the power actually, locally available resources, raw material, the labor, and all other facilities which are available in the skilled labor or skilled workers and the market and demand, etc. Everything is available locally. That is natural cluster, which develops of its own. When the facilities are there, people start establishing their industry, their units in that particular area, because that area is convenient, that particular location is convenient for them to start the functioning. Then the induced cluster, where the efforts are made, the government of India or other state governments can make the efforts. So those units which come up at a location due to a specific investment policy or the public provision of specialized infrastructure. Now, there has to be some agency, or there has to be the local government or the central government. They want a particular location, the cluster should come up. Then they can provide the facility and the cluster may start forming at that place, which is called induced. So we have discussed natural cluster, induced cluster. Now the vertical and the horizontal cluster. This is another type of cluster. Vertical cluster is when it consists of one or a few large enterprises. We are talking about few large enterprises and a large number of other small supplier enterprises is a vertical cluster. We can say if in Gurgaon, Maruti factory is there, then nearby there will be tire suppliers also, there will be steering wheel suppliers also, there will be nut board supplier also. So that is a vertical cluster, because in that situation, if we find that in the vertical cluster, one or few large enterprises are there and a large number of other small supplier enterprises are there. In the horizontal cluster, it consists of a large number of small and medium sized enterprises, often in hundreds, that may produce and market directly while competing with one another. So these are similar kind of units which are marketing and competing with one another, right? So this is the difference between vertical cluster and horizontal cluster. So the SME in horizontal cluster may, however, have other supplier firms in the same cluster. As we told in the horizontal cluster, only we are talking about similar kind of other suppliers, other firms, type of firms also can be there. Features of the cluster. The cluster have common challenges and opportunities. We have already discussed this. Similar level of technology and structure for infrastructure is used. Similarity or complementarity in the methods of production, quality control, testing, energy consumption, pollution control, etc. has to be there. That is the basic feature of the units functioning in one cluster. Then cluster approach. What is the cluster approach? The broad operating factors of MSME clusters. This approach we'll discuss. So these MSME units, they work on low cost labor, traditional skills, technological obsolescence, change in the techniques. So technological obsolescence means all will be found struggling with the old technology, and they will be in pursuit of the new technology for which they would they may apply loans from the banks. They can try the resources, because this is one of the major issues which has been found in the MSMEs, that the technology that they are using is obsolete. Then the cluster approach provides social and inter-organizational linkages with which a small firm is linked. These linkages help to provide various types of technical, commercial, and legal services. So all these units functioning in that particular area, so the approach provides social and inter-organizational linkages with which a firm is linked. So this enables the MSMEs to overcome some of their inherent disadvantages, like economies of scale. Now, what is economy of scale? Economy scale is when a large quantity is produced, then the cost of production is reduced considerably. Suppose one particular MSME unit is manufacturing one pen, then the cost will be quite high. But if and then the profit margin will not be there. And if at all they are producing large number of pen units, that particular unit is producing large number of pen, then of course the cost per pen will be quite reduced, and the profitability can be improved. So this is what is the meaning of economies of scale. So we are discussing this enables the MSMEs to overcome some of their inherent disadvantages, like economies of scale, sourcing and acquisition of technology, and specialized production functions. The pattern of inter-firm collaboration, both at horizontal and vertical levels. We have already discussed what is horizontal cluster, what is vertical cluster. So at horizontal and vertical level, raise technical know-how, accelerate innovation, and improve the ability of small producers to respond to external market development. What is the meaning of it? The pattern of inter-firm collaboration. Now there are hundreds of MSMEs which are producing similar kind of product, which are using similar kind of technology. So the inter-firm collaboration, they will be having some kind of collaboration between them or amongst them. So that will both at horizontal and vertical levels raise the technical know-how, because they come to know that that particular unit is better using better technology. They are using better know-how, technological know-how. So the other unit also would like to improve their own technology. That is the problem in the first item we have discussed, technological obsolescence. That means the technology normally is found to be obsolete. So if other units have started using some improved technology, the similar technology would like to be used by other MSME units which are working in a cluster. Suppose they are not working in a cluster, then they will continue to use the same technology, because for changing or improving the technology, it will be very, very costly affair. Broad operating factors of MSME clusters. Where large number of industrial units are located, producing somewhat similar products with varying degrees of quality levels. Such units cannot be defined as cluster groups because of the following deficiencies. These are promoted by initiative of some institutions like SIDBI and are mainly industrial enterprises. Now, difference between industrial enterprises and MSME, you probably understand. The industry is a very big, large industry, and MSME is small units using the locally available resources either or with the help of the government initiative. The efforts are mainly on technology. However, the integration of various other factors are not in their agenda. The involvement of all the beneficiary firms in all initiatives is quite limited. Cluster approach, challenges, and benefits. The two main challenges of MSMEs are to upgrade themselves from local, national, to global market. Now, MSMEs, they are contributing quite a bit in our economy. They are exporting the manufactured goods, but they are facing a lot of competition globally. Number two, the meet competition through superior quality and technology upgradation. This is a major challenge before the MSMEs. Technology upgradation, number one, and superior quality products. Unless and until they do at a lower cost, they will not stand in the global market. The benefits of cluster approach of MSME is access to information, knowledge, skill, and finance locally in the cluster only. They can have linkages with market and suppliers, because all suppliers and all purchasers, the buyers, they will rush to the cluster. They would definitely find it convenient to go to a cluster, do their shopping in a cluster rather than going to a secluded place and do for doing the shoppings. They can correct inadequate strategies and improve organization. They can overcome inefficient regulations and take advantage of existing incentives. So these are the benefits of cluster approach. If in the cluster the units are functioning, then definitely some benefits are derived by all the units. Now, the cluster approach can develop inter-firm cooperation culture, cooperation plus competition, flexibility and efficiency, continuous upgradation of production, markets, skills and technology, increased innovation, joint learning, and collective efficiency. So this is again a benefit of functioning in a cluster. Now, enhancing MSME competitiveness through cluster development. Now, in this table, we are seeing the nature of deficiencies in MSMEs and the remedies sought through cluster initiative. The individualistic and non-sharing, this is the deficiency, and the remedy is awareness and trust building interactions among the cluster participants. We have discussed earlier also, and same thing we are discussing here also. Second is lack of collective thing. To bring about, the remedy is to bring about effective idealization and participation, networking, both within and outside the cluster. The deficiency is high costs, because most of the time, economy of scale is not there. So if high cost is there, then that remedy is consortium approach. Consortium means where more than one units are involved, more than one units are involved, that is a cluster. Consortium approach in procurement of raw material, that means all the units, suppose one particular unit is purchasing the raw material, the transport cost will be higher. But if all the units put together are purchasing the raw material, the transport cost can be divided. So consortium approach in procurement of raw material, contracts and financing, sharing of costs of common services. There are various common services that cost can be shared. Low quality is another deficiency. Common testing and R&D facilities. The government of India is providing testing facilities. So for the testing facilities, if it is available locally, then the common testing facilities, the cost can be shared and the quality also can be improved. Awareness programs on quality management, benchmarking. What is benchmarking? A particular unit, the level of that unit is, the quality of that unit can be taken as a benchmark. Means all other units should manufacture at least, their product should at least match this particular product, which is a benchmark product. So that is benchmarking. Low market penetration, another deficiency. Remedy, product innovation, product diversification, market information and market diversification, strategies and market research. Another deficiency, lack of or poor brand image. Normally it is seen MSMEs do not carry the brand image. It is only once the MSME develops into a large industrial unit, big industry unit, then only a brand image is created. So the remedy is brand building, brand imaging, co-branding, and brand management. Enhancing MSME competitiveness through cluster development. The nature of deficiencies in MSMEs: low capital, low debt, and poor financial management. This is a very common deficiency. The remedy is improved access to debt market, where from loan can be taken. It can be bank also. It can be public also. They can issue the bonds. They can issue the debentures. So local access to improved access to debt market. Skill building in financial and accounting management. That is also another problem with MSMEs. They do not know the accounting part of it. That skill is missing in them. Then build bridges of understanding between the financing institution and entrepreneurs for better facilitation, innovation of new financial product to suit the specific product of the market. Because the MSME may need the term loan also, they may need the working capital loan also, they may need the off balance sheet items that facilities also. It is like bank guarantee or letter of credit. Suppose some goods have to be imported, I mean the raw material has to be imported, then of course the import facilities also, they require import finance facilities, they require. And if they are exporting, then their bills discounting facility they may require. So all those things, low capital, low debt, and poor financial management, this can be mitigated. And these are the remedies we have already discussed. Now, next is lack of institutional support. The institution building and building strong public-private partnership in building product specific and general infrastructure. So in a cluster environment, all these remedies are available. Then the last one is lack of enthusiasm and disinterested second generation entrepreneurs. The remedy is entrepreneurship development program specially designed for the cluster. These such kind of programs are run in the cluster by various stakeholders, various institutions. Selection of a cluster development approach, how we can select. Number one, identification of the cluster in the country, creation of a country cluster table and map, preliminary selection and shortlist of cluster, formulation of final selection criteria, and final selection. So we will discuss it one by one. Identification of clusters. Since cluster development is relatively a new approach in the field of MSME development, an inventory of cluster has to be prepared. And for a proper cluster selection, is required for a proper cluster selection. Hence, clusters selection can be done only with the secondary source combined with expert opinion. So we'll discuss in the forthcoming slides. Source of information is statistical parameters that have been used in countries like foreign countries. I mean, in India, various databases not available because UNIDO has done some work in that area, but actually that is not perfect and that is not complete. In fact, as per UNIDO report, 388 big industrial units are there. Industrial units are there, clusters are there, not the big industry unit. 388 clusters are there, of the same number, equal number are there, micro institution. But these are the old data. Latest data are not available. So the statistical parameters have been used in countries like Italy and UK to build proper database. Details such as indices of concentration, stage of cluster development, depth, variety of cluster shareholders, dynamics, growing or declining, economics of significance, regional, national, or international information are gathered in addition to statistics. So in our country, MSME support institutions can play a useful role in assisting these teams. There are various institutions which are working, functioning for the benefit of this cluster and cluster development. So from there, the database can be taken. So friends, here we break, and this is our one session. We will start our second session after some time. So this is our first session about cluster and cluster development is here that ends. Thank you very much.